Namaskar. The topic of discussion in this lesson is on the geography of Tamil Nadu. India is a land of diversities. The geography of India is an essential aspect to be understood by every student in this country. As a nation, India occupies a very significant position in the world. It is a country known for its unique culture, history, heritage, natural resources, and human capital. India is a union of states. For administrative reasons, the country is divided into 28 states and 7 union territories. Each part of India is unique in its geography and socio-economic conditions. Tamil Nadu is one of the prominent states in India. The main objectives of learning this lesson are to know about its geographic setting, people, governance, and contribution in the country. The aspects which are covered in this module are the physiographic setting, the climate, rainfall, and land cover, the administrative divisions and population, the economic resources and contributors, culture, tourism, and unique features of the state as a whole.
The physiographic setting. Based on the physiographic characteristics, Tamil Nadu state has been divided into 4 major morphological regions comprising of the coastal plains, eastern ghats, central plateau, and western ghats. Geographically, the state of Tamil Nadu lies between northern latitude of 8.5 minutes and 13.35 minutes and the eastern longitude of 76.15 minutes and 80.20 minutes. Tamil Nadu occupies the eastern side of the Indian peninsula. This is the 11th largest state in India by area, covering 1,30,058 square kilometers. It lies in the southernmost part of the Indian peninsula. It is bordered by Andhra Pradesh in the north, Karnataka and Kerala in the west, Bay of Bengal in the east, and Indian Ocean in the south. Establishment. The state of Tamil Nadu in modern India has been under continuous human habitation since prehistoric times. The history of Tamil Nadu and the civilization of the native people are among the oldest in the world, dating back to 500 BCE. Since 15th August 1947, the state was known as Madras Province. In 1950, it attained separate statehood. During 1969, Madras Province was renamed as Tamil Nadu. Official language. Tamil is the official language and spoken by 89.43% of the population. It has been in use in inscriptions and literature for over 2,000 years. The other Indian languages spoken in this state include Telugu, 5.65%, Kannada, 1.68%, Urdu, 1.51%, Malayalam, 0.89%, Gujarati, Saurashtri, 0.32%, Hindi, 0.30%, and Marathi, 0.10%. Tamil Nadu is divided naturally between the flat country along the eastern coast and the hilly regions in the north and west. The broadest part of the eastern plains is the fertile Kaveri River Delta. The plains extend farther south as arid flatlands. The high peaks of the western ghats run along the state's western border. Various segments of this mountain range include the Nilgiri, Anai Malai, and Palani Hills, rising their peaks exceeding 2,400 meters above mean sea level. Anai Mudi, called as Anai Peak, at 2,695 meters above mean sea level, located in the Anai Malai Hills, is the highest mountain in this region. The lower peaks of the Eastern Ghats and their outliers, locally called Jawad, Kalrayan, and Chevroy Hills, all run through the center of this region. Surface water potential. Tamil Nadu is home to many natural resources. The total surface water potential of the river basins of Tamil Nadu is assessed as 24,160 million cubic meters. There are 39,000 tanks with a storage capacity of 347 TMSA and 79 reservoirs with storage capacity of 243 TMSA available in the state. There are 17 major river basins in this state. Groundwater potential. Nearly 73% of the total area of Tamil Nadu state is occupied by a variety of hard and fissured crystalline rocks like charnockite, gneisses, and granites. The depth of open wells varies from 6 to 30 meters below ground level, while the depth of borewells varies from 30 to 100 meters. The sedimentary formations consist of sandstones, limestones, and shales, whereas quaternary sediments in the state are represented by older alluvium and recent alluvium and coastal sands. In the Kaveri Delta of Tanjavur district, there are plenty of artesian wells with free flow up to 270 meter cubed per hour. The yield of wells in the alluvium varies from 27 to 212 meter cubed per hour. The yield of wells in the fissured formations varies from 7 to 35 meter cubed per hour. The climate, temperature, seasons, and weather. The climate of Tamil Nadu is tropical in nature, with little variation in summer and winter temperatures. While April, May, June are the hottest summer months, with a temperature rising up to 40 degrees centigrade, November to February is the coolest winter period, with temperature lowering around 20 degrees centigrade, making the climate quite pleasant. The northeast monsoon is the major contributor of the state of Tamil Nadu between October and December. The state also receives substantial rainfall during southwest monsoon and non-monsoonal season. According to statistics, the average annual rainfall in Tamil Nadu is between 635 and 1,905 millimeters. During summer, April, June, the coastal regions of Tamil Nadu become uncomfortably warm, humid, but the cool sea breezes in the afternoon make nights cool and pleasant. Natural regions. Tamil Nadu has a good amount of forest cover. The total area under forests is 21,431 square kilometers. The hills of the Western Ghats have dense forests as compared to Eastern Ghats. This region receives maximum rainfall and hence favors plantations of tea, coffee, and spices. The upper reaches of the Eastern Ghats also share the beauty. Yerkod in the Chevroy Hills is famous for its fruit orchards, banana, and coffee plantations. The most arid and drought-prone area of Tamil Nadu are in the Ramanathapuram, Shivaganga, Tuticorin, and Tirunelveli districts. Tamil Nadu is drained by a few major rivers like the Kaveri, the Ponnaiyar, the Palar, the Vaigai, and the Tamrapurni. All of them flow eastward, originating from western ghats. The state has about 5,250 rain-fed tanks. Large number of small lakes and a few major lakes are also found in the state. Geology. Geologically, the state has formations ranging from the oldest to the youngest. The Precambrian crystalline rocks cover over 80% of the terrain of the state of Tamil Nadu. The Phanerozoic sedimentary rocks cover the eastern coastal terrain and river valleys. Within this, a vast array of crystalline rocks, igneous emplacement of anorthosites, granites, syenites, carbonatites, ultramafic bodies, and basic silts and dikes occur. The Phanerozoic rocks of fluviatile, fluviomarine, and marine origin occur along the eastern coastal belt. Soils. The state is characterized by a rich alluvial soil occurring along the river deltas. Clays, loams, sands, and red laterites are also predominantly present. The black cotton-growing soil, known as regur, is found in the central, west central, and southeastern regions of Tamil Nadu. The administrative divisions, population, and education. Tamil Nadu state has a population of 7.2138 million as per census 2011. The major administrative units of the state constitute 32 districts, 76 revenue divisions, 220 taluks, 10 municipal corporations, 125 municipalities, 385 panchayat unions or blocks, 529 town panchayats, and 12,524 village panchayats. There are 39 parliamentary and 234 assembly constituents in Tamil Nadu. It is one of the most urbanized states in India. Districts of Tamil Nadu. Chennai is the capital city of Tamil Nadu. The districts of the state are Ariyalur, Chennai, Coimbatore, Kadalur, Dharmapuri, Dindigal, Erode, Kanchipuram, Kanyakumari, Karur, Krishnagiri, Madurai, Nagapattinam, Namakkal, Nilgiris, Perambular, Pudukottai, Ramanathapuram, Salem, Shivaganga, Tanjavur, Theni district, Thoothukudi district, Thiruvarur, Thirunalveli, Tiruchirappalli, Thiruvallur, Tiruppur, Thiruvannamalai, Vellur, Villupuram, Virudhanagar. Population. As per census 2011, Tamil Nadu has a population of 72.138 million. It is the seventh most densely populated state in India. The population density is 555 persons per square kilometer of the total population. Male and female are 36.16 million and 35.98 million respectively. The population of Tamil Nadu forms 5.96% of India in 2011. 44% of the state's population lives in urban areas, the highest among large states in India. Literacy rate in Tamil Nadu is 80.33%. Of that, male literacy stands at 86.81%, while female literacy is at 73.86%. The sex ratio of Tamil Nadu is 995 female for each 1,000 males. This is above the national average of 940 as per Census 2011. India has a Human Development Index calculated as 0.619, while the corresponding figure for Tamil Nadu is 0.736, placing it among the top states in India. The life expectancy at birth for males is 65.2 years, and for females, it is 67.6 years. The dominant ethnic group of the state is the Tamil population. The people of the state are belonging to various religions, including Hinduism, Christianity, Islam, and Jainism. The percentage of people belonging to Hindu religion cover about 88% of the total population. Christians and Muslims together make about 11%, and remaining belong to the other religions. Economic resources and contributors. Forests. Tamil Nadu is endowed with rich forest cover in Western Ghats, Eastern Ghats, and along the coastal plains. The state of Tamil Nadu is a pioneer in the conservation of endangered tropical plant species. It has established a gene pool garden over an area of 242.14 hectares at Nadugani of Nilgiris district. A total of 451 species have been assembled in this garden. Apart from this, Tamil Nadu has established 12 medicinal plants conservation areas and 8 medicinal plant development areas for conservation and propagation of medicinal plants. The angiosperm diversity of Tamil Nadu, with 5,640 species, ranks first among all states in the country. The faunal diversity of Tamil Nadu includes 165 freshwater fishes, 76 species of amphibians, 177 species of reptiles, 454 species of birds, and 187 species of mammals. Mineral resources. The important minerals of commercial value in Tamil Nadu are granite, lignite, limestone, and natural gas. Tamil Nadu accounts for about 90% of the lignite potential in the country. Lignite constitutes a major mineral base for generation of power and production of fertilizers. Manganese deposits in Salem are the largest in India. It provides the raw material for the manufacture of refractory materials. Granite is one of the export earners from Tamil Nadu. Limestone forms the base for cement and chemical industries. Salt is found all along the coast, and it is manufactured in large scale at Tuticorin. The other minerals which occur in the state of Tamil Nadu are mica, chromites, and bauxite. Energy resources. Tamil Nadu state has various forms of renewable energy sources, that is, wind, solar, biomass, biogas, small hydro, etc. Municipal and industrial wastes are also used as sources of energy. Renewable energy sources are regenerative, non-depleting, environment-friendly, and sustainable. Industry. Tamil Nadu has the highest number of business enterprises and stands second in total employment in India. Coimbatore, Tirupur, and Erode are well known for textile industries. Karur is a hub for bus body building industries. Namakkal is the major source of heavy vehicle and lorry body building. Bharat Heavy Electricals Limited, one of India's largest electrical equipment manufacturing companies, has manufacturing plants at Tiruchirappalli and Ranipet. the state government owns the Tamil Nadu Newsprint and Papers Limited. A large number of cement factories are situated in and around Ariyalur, which is the land of cement industries in the state. Namakkal is one of the main source of egg production in India. Shivakashi is a major center of fireworks, safety match production, and offset printing in India. Over 60% of the firework production in India is contributed from Shivakashi. Agriculture. Agriculture is the mainstay of life for about half the working population of Tamil Nadu. Since very early times, the farmers have skillfully conserved scarce rainwater in small and large irrigation reservoirs or tanks. Government canals, tube wells, and ordinary wells also form part of the irrigation system. Several of the river valley projects depend on water from monsoonal rain. Crop production. Tamil Nadu has historically been regarded as an agricultural state. It is a leading producer of many agricultural products in India. In 2008, Tamil Nadu was India's fifth biggest producer of rice. The other principal crops for domestic consumption are millet and other cereals, as well as peanuts or groundnuts and pulses such as chickpeas. Sugarcane, cotton, cashews, and chilies are the important cash crops. Many farmers in Tamil Nadu also raise livestock, primarily cows, especially for the dairy industry, poultry, goats, and sheep. Marine resources. The coastline of Tamil Nadu has a length of about 1,076 kilometers. It constitutes about 15% of the total coastal length of India and stretches along the Bay of Bengal, the Indian Ocean, and a part of the Arabian Sea. Fisheries is one of the important food production sectors in Tamil Nadu. It is contributing to the livelihood as well as food security of a large section of the economically underprivileged population. More than 0.8 million people depend directly on fisheries for their livelihood, and a larger population in Tamil Nadu is indirectly dependent on it. The unique topography of Tamil Nadu, with the Gulf of Mannar and Kanyakumari in the south, and Pulikat Lake, which is the second largest lagoon in the country in the north, has resulted in an abundance of endemic species and a large number of high-value potential resources. They include spiny lobsters, crabs, flower shrimps, coral fish, sea bass, groupers, sea breams, mullets, gastropods, abalones, chanks, pearl oysters, etc. Nearly one-third of the seaweed resources of the Indian Ocean are found along the east coast of Tamil Nadu, particularly along the Gulf of Mannar. Transport. Tamil Nadu has a well-established round-the-clock transportation system that connects all parts of the state. There are 24 national highways in the state, covering a total distance of 2,002 kilometers. Tamil Nadu has a total railway track length of 6,693 kilometers. There are 690 railway stations in the state. Tamil Nadu has the major international airport, Chennai International Airport, which is connected with 19 countries with more than 329 direct flights every day. Other international airports of Tamil Nadu include Coimbatore and Trichy. There are two small airports, one at Madurai and another at Tuticorin. Tamil Nadu has three major seaports at Chennai, Ennore, and Tuticorin. It has seven minor ports located at Rameshwaram, Kanyakumari, Kadalur, Kolachel, Karaikal, Pamban, and Valinokkam. all are currently capable of handling a major cargo component every year. Natural hazards. Tamil Nadu is prone to cyclones and storm surge in the coastal regions. It is experiencing less intensity earthquakes, monsoon floods, landslides, and tsunami. Special economic zones. A special economic zone is a geographical region that has more specific features like free trade zones, export processing zones, free zones, industrial estates, free ports, urban enterprise zones, and others. Some of the major special economic zones of Tamil Nadu include ETA Technopark Private Limited, Old Mahabalipuram Road, Navallur Village, Chengalpet Taluk, Electronics Corporation of Tamil Nadu at Kanchipuram. Culture. Tamil Nadu is known for its long and rich tradition of literature, music, and dance, which continue to flourish even today. The unique cultural features like Bharatanatyam dance, Tanjore painting, and Tamil architecture were developed and continue to be practiced in Tamil Nadu. Literature. Most early Tamil literary works are in verse form. Notable examples of Tamil poetry include the Thirukkural, written during the Tamil Sangam's period. When India adopted national standards, Tamil was the very first language to be recognized as a classical language of India. Education and social development. Tamil Nadu is one of the most literate states in India. Tamil Nadu has 37 universities, 455 engineering colleges, 449 polytechnic colleges, and 566 arts and science colleges, 34,335 elementary schools, 5,167 high schools, 5,054 higher secondary schools, and 5,000 hospitals. The University of Madras is one of the oldest universities in India. Tourism. Tamil Nadu's tourism industry is the second largest in India. It has an annual growth of 16%. Tourism is promoted by Tamil Nadu Tourism Development Corporation, a government of Tamil Nadu undertaking. The tagline adopted for promoting tourism in Tamil Nadu is Enchanting Tamil Nadu. In this state, the temples are of a distinct style, renowned for their towering gopurams. Madurai Meenakshi Temple is one of the grandest Hindu temples in the world. The temples of Srirangam, Tanjavur, Srivilliputtur, Tiruvannamalai, and Kumbakonam regions are the most popular ones. Basilica of Our Lady of Good Health at Velankani is one of the major pilgrimage centers for Christians. Irwadi Darga in the Ramanathapuram district is one of the major pilgrimage centers of Muslims in Tamil Nadu. Samanars or Tamil Jains have a legacy dating back to 250 BC. Tamil Nadu is also home to beautiful hill stations like Udagamandalam or Uti, Kodaikanal, Yerkad, Kunur, Topslip, Valparai, Yelagiri, and Manjolai. The mangrove forests at Pichavaram are also ecotourism spots of importance. Kanyakumari, the southernmost tip of peninsular India, is famous for its beautiful sunrise, Vivekananda Rock Memorial, and Tiruvalluvar statue built off the coastline. Marina Beach in Chennai is one of the longest beaches in the world. Sports, Kabaddi, also known locally as Sadu Gudu, is the state game of Tamil Nadu. But the most popular game, just like rest of India, is cricket. The Sports Development Authority of Tamil Nadu is the government body that is vested with the responsibility of developing sports and related infrastructure in the state. M.A. Chidambaram Stadium in Chennai is an international cricketing arena with a capacity of 50,000. It houses the Tamil Nadu Cricket Association. History. Tamil Nadu's history dates back to the prehistoric times. Archaeological evidence points to this area being one of the longest continuous habitations in India. In Adichanallur, 24 kilometers from Tirunelveli, archaeologists from the Archaeological Survey of India unearthed 169 clay urns containing human skulls, skeletons and bones, plus husks and grains of rice, charred rice and Neolithic Celts, giving evidence confirming them to be of the Neolithic period 3,800 years ago. The Cholas, who were very active during the Sangam age, were entirely absent during the first few centuries. During the 4th to 8th centuries, Tamil Nadu saw the rise of the Pallavas under Mahendravarman I and his son Mamalla Narasimhavarman I and his uncle Bodhidharma. The Pallavas were replaced by the Cholas as the dominant kingdom in the 10th century. They, in turn, were replaced by Pandyas in the 13th century. The Muslim invasion led to the establishment of the short-lived Madurai Sultanate. Around 1609, the Dutch established a settlement in Pulikat, while the Danish had their establishment in Trankubar or Tarangambadi. In 1639, the British, under the British East India Company, established a settlement further south of Pulikat, which is the present-day Chennai. The Madras Presidency was a notable region in the history of British India. When India became independent in 1947, Madras Presidency became Madras State. Monuments and forts. The state has several monuments and forts. The thought of Mahabalipuram reminds us of Arjuna's penance, which is an enormous relief made on two huge boulders. Chennai is privileged with many ancient monuments, including Madras War Cemetery, Senate House, and Ripon Building, and the Tirumalai Naikar Mahal is a classic example of Indo-Saracenic style monument in Madurai. Unique features. Tamil architecture is one of the states in India known for its ancient kings, zamindars, freedom fighters, and notable personalities, including former presidents of India, famous dancers, musicians, poets, writers, film actors, chief ministers, central ministers, academicians, philosophers, religious gurus, and scholars of all walks of life. Makara Sankranti is the festival of harvest. Deepavali, Ayudha Puja, Vinayaka Chaturthi, Saraswati Puja, Christmas, Eid al-Fitr, Easter, and Bakrid are the major festivals of Tamil Nadu.
So far, we have seen only some salient features of the geography of the state. There are a lot more things to be studied about this state. We will see them in the future modules.